firmly believe that blacks should be proud that they are black. I love my state and all its people, both black and white. In the height of the madness, NBC wanted this Mary from Summit to be on national TV in a self-portrait of Mississippi. Well, they didn't fool me for a minute. I knew what they wanted. They wanted to portray an ignorant, redneck Southern slamming the black race. In that interview, I did my very best to tell them what I truly believed. Because deep down, I knew the evil in their hearts. They wanted to use me. Kind of reminded me of a time recently when someone told me about the new library at Ole Miss and all the new authors that would be included in the collection. Well, I had to admit that I knew that a lot of people believe Mississippi is at the bottom of the culture ladder. But I quickly added, Mississippians may not read books, but they sure do write them. But I believe that I brought a sincere desire to serve my state honestly and with all the wisdom and intelligence that God gave me.
Well, you know, when we look back and remember how it was, we also have to remember how it is today. A Chevrolet Malibu would cost $22,000. A new home, $200,000, and a postage stamp, 49 cents. Howell's service station is a gift shop. If you want something to eat, you go to the store of Dorita's. There's a statue of a pink pig in front of the city hall to commemorate smoking on the track. An annual celebration. Mary Kane's gone, but her words and spirit remain. City of New Orleans runs only twice a day. The merchants on Robb Street are fighting new battles and hunting larger with them. Ah, but the splendor of memories and the innocence of a safer time. We're so tempted to look back and say,